The southeast has the unenviable reputation of being the credit card and check fraud center of Europe. Con artists use stolen cards and checkbooks to buy goods. The richest pickings used to be in London stores, but sales assistants in the capital, anxious to net rewards for catching criminals, are pushing the tricksters out into the home counties. Manageress Tracy Mortimer says she can spot a fraudster the minute they walk into her store. At Christmas, she was working in Bromley. Her and her colleagues stopped two or three every day, earning £800 in rewards in just 1 week.
Basically, they'll come into the store and they'll pick high-priced merchandise up to the £50, sizes that aren't relevant to them, and take it straight to the cash desk without trying it on.
Fraud has soared in Guildford, 170 cases in the past 12 months. Police are linking it with the growing number of thefts of chequebooks and credit cards from vehicles. Mary Smithers is one victim. Her car was broken into on Boxing Day and her handbag stolen.
My statement came through the following month. I thought, oh hell, there should be more money than that in there. I then went to Jaro Bank, who issued me with photocopies of the cheques. When they arrived, only to see that it wasn't my writing, it wasn't my signature. Well, a good attempt at my signature, but not my signatures.
Seminars like these are the way forward, according to Surrey Police and Gyro Bank. Together, they've launched a spring offensive to stamp out fraud, educating sales assistants to stop fraudsters in their tracks. Staff can earn £50 every time they prevent a crime.
There's a lot of research going on with the banks at the moment, particularly with the high-tech stuff that's coming along. Photographs is another area being researched. But even so, at the end of the day, it will still need the cooperation and the assistance of the person at the point of sale to interpret what they see.
But fraud is big business, and it's a business that's costing British industry at least £300 million every year. Sally Arthie in Guildford for Thames News.